Good morning, everyone. I would like to acknowledge the arrival of Deputy Governor, Her Honor, Ms. Hylisa M. Liebert, OBEMH. Welcome to the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School's graduation ceremony. You may all, we actually would invite Mrs. Shirley Allen to open our ceremony with a prayer.
Good morning to all. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. At this time, I would like to ask the student to please join hands together. Praise the Lord. First, before I pray for the children, I'm here to say thank you for all the well wishes. Thank you for the parents. Thank you for all the teachers. Thank you for all of you who have in your heart best wishes for those children. Father God in heaven, this morning, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your love. We thank you for this great opportunity this morning that we could find ourselves in this place to celebrate with these children, dear God. Father God in heaven, Lord Jesus, I pray that you may open up the understanding. Give them wisdom, give them knowledge. Help them, oh God, to understand that the thing that they are going into right now, Jesus, is for their own benefit. Help them, oh Lord God, to pursue good and not evil. Father in heaven, oh God, help them, oh God, to do the right things in life. Oh, blessed be the name of Jesus. Help them, oh Lord God, to walk right in the name of Jesus. Help them, oh Lord God, to focus on what they are about to do in the name of Jesus. Father in heaven, oh God, they left primary school, about to go to high school. Help them, oh God, not to forget where they come from in the name of Jesus. Father in heaven, oh God, help them to build up a love in their heart for their school, and not only for their school and for adults on their side in the name of Jesus, to be respectful to others and for themselves, dear God, in the name of Jesus. And help them, oh God, this morning that they may not take things for granted in the name of Jesus and forget about the bad things. Majority of time when they left primary school, they think they are big woman and big man. Father, in the name of Jesus, help them, oh God, to focus and do the right thing in the name of Jesus and forget the gun and the drugs and other stuff that is not pleasing unto you, dear Jesus. Father in heaven, oh God, give them the strength to carry on, dear God, and help them to walk the right way. And I thank God for everything what I will be saying this morning. Touch each and everybody this morning that will be performing, dear Lord God. Bless them and cover them under your blood. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you so much, Ms. Allen, for blessing our ceremony here this morning. I now welcome Zeandra Robinson, Sanaya Liebert, and Zanye Myers to sing the national anthem. Please welcome them.
Thank you.
such a beautiful rendition. You may all be seated. I know we've been waiting to hear that one. I would like to invite Miss Kenya Gittens to give us a warm welcome in the form of a poem.
Special words. Some words are special. They tell you how we feel. Some words share feelings that can never be contained. Today we share a special word with you. It's welcome. To let you know, we are glad you're here at this our graduation and prize-giving ceremony. We hope you enjoyed this program thoroughly. A special, special welcome extended to everyone everywhere.
I honestly hope I'll be able to top such a welcome. However, before I begin, I would like to recognize Your Honor, Ms. Hylita M. Liburd, OBE MH, our Deputy Governor General, the Honorable Mark A.G. Brantley, Premier and Minister of Finance, Statistics, Economic Planning, Human Resources, Industry, Trade, and Consumer Affairs et al., the Honorable Yu Choi Liburd, Minister with Responsibility for Education and Information Technology, Library Services, Youth and Sports, Mr. Kevin F. Barrett, Permanent Secretary, Minister of Education, Library Services, Information Technology, Youth and Sports, Ms. Zanella Claxton, Principal Education Officer for the Department of Education. Mrs. Therese Dorr, Education Officer assigned to the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School. Other education officials, principal, staff and teachers, parents, supporters, well-wishers, specially invited guests, members of the media, class of 2023, I bid you a pleasant good morning. I love the response. It is indeed a pleasure to be chosen as the chair for your graduation ceremony. And for some reason, I am intimidated to be standing in front of the graduation class this morning, despite, you know, all the ministers in the room. Class of 2023. You are in this auditorium because you have proven yourself capable and determined to take your educational journey seriously. As the theme for your graduation ceremony says, it's the opportune time to become a better, stronger, and more genuine version of yourself. I can go on and on about the obstacles you may face as you take your next steps. And this being the start of an amazing journey. However, today is the day of celebration and recognition of your hard work, years and years of hard work and play. So I encourage you to observe every moment, for the memory will last. We are gathered here under the patronage of Miss Kirstel Brown, and I invite her to stand and be recognized at this time. I can tell that she's beaming with honor and pride to be given such an honor and be here with you this morning. I now invite the principal, Mrs. Jessica Liburd, to give you the principal's report. Please welcome her as she comes.
I observe previous protocols having been established by your chairperson. Good morning, everyone. And a special good morning to Her Honor, Mrs. Hylita Liebert, our Deputy Governor General, and the graduating class of 2023. Five years ago, in September 2018, I was the grade two teacher of this graduating class sitting here today. Sadly, my stint with them was short-lived when I left for university in the UK 1 month later. Little did I know, it was God's plan to bring me back to this institution where I became their new principal in September of 2022, which gave me an opportunity to spend some more time with them before they ended their final leg of primary school. It is therefore without reservation that I say that these graduates have a special spot in my heart. The academic year 2022-2023 began on September 29th, August 2022, when the Education Department ensured that teachers and staff were ready for the new academic year with a back-to-school convocation. This was held under the theme, Education for the Future, Reflect, Refocus, Recalibrate. To ensure this theme resonated throughout the year, several workshops and staff professional development sessions were held internally and externally by the department. The year began with a total of 76 students, 46 boys and 30 girls, and a full staff of 26. Mrs. Jessica Liebert, yours truly as principal, Ms. Tamisha Sadler, deputy, Ms. Bibi Hussein, kindergarten, Ms. Shoya Lawrence, grade one, who joined the staff this school year, Ms. Clarissa Hanley and Ms. Drusilla Paris, grade two, Ms. Renisha Hobson, grade three, Ms. Delisha Doe, grade four, Ms. Kimisha Sutton, grade five, and our grade six teacher, who has helped to prepare our students for today, Ms. Shabana Powell. Our reading specialist teacher, Ms. Suzette Fraser, who specifically deals with students from grade one to three, while Mrs. Judy Usher, our reading remediation teacher for the upper grades and our morning devotions coordinator. Ms. Kellyanne Descent joined the staff, replacing Ms. Amira Bertie, the computer teacher who left for her further studies. Our librarian, Ms. Sharon Liebert, and guidance counselor, Mrs. Shabana Prince. Our reverberant physical education officers, Mr. Adelvin Phillip and Ms. Sienna Leader. The one who helps to keep the staff alert and updated is our very own Mrs. Kishma Wilkin Bartlett, who is our school secretary. Our auxiliary staff comprises of our all-rounder attendance security officer, Mr. Marcellus Lee, who complements our staff of mostly ladies. Ms. Sophie Lanz and Ms. Diane Prentice, who work exceptionally together to ensure we have a clean environment around the clock, along with Mrs. Janet Bryan, who comes after school. Our cooks, who keep the students on the lunch program well-nourished, are Mrs. Dahlia Brown, Ms. Sandra Hobson, Ms. Renella Brooks, and Ms. Calissa Julius. Ms. Karen Bell, our crossing guard, and our liaison officers, PC Pemberton, PC Oliveira, PC Charles, PC Roman, and Constable Ali, all help in keeping our school a safe place for all. Our chaplain, Pastor Euclid and Mrs. Lawrence, who reinforce our weekly virtues, and finally, Mr. Wilbur Claxton, who is our landscaper. Our teachers and staff have worked hard collaboratively throughout the year to ensure that all students achieve their fullest potential. It was not all smooth sailing, but I leave this quote from Jack Canfield with my staff, and I quote, "When you embrace change, you will begin to see it has an opportunity for growth," end of quote. Let us continue to work together to take EPPS to higher grounds. During the academic year, there were numerous activities, initiatives, and achievements. From September 9th to 15th, 2022, students wore the different colors of the country's national flag for National Colored Days, and the week was culminated with an independence display. Then a contingent of students, led by our grade four teacher, Ms. Delisha Doar, represented our school with distinction at the annual Independence Parade. Our student council elections saw Mr. Kyan Blake winning as president, along with his teammates, Kizia Griffin, Cleston Bartlett, Janiah Powell, and Robert Chapman. During the month of October, the Department of Gender Affairs visited for the International Day of the Girl Child and awarded Jayla Gilfillan of Grade 5 with this award. For International Artist Day, our librarian, Ms. Sharon Liebert, invited a local artist, Mr. Davian Griffin, who visited a few classes and taught students some basic drawing techniques, which the students really enjoyed. Mrs. Pazzi Wilkin Literacy Link for Hands Across the Sea visited, as well as bringing books and library supplies. During the month of November, the Department of Agriculture hosted a school's gardening competition dubbed School Agro, in which our school placed second in the category of field garden. Kudos to Mr. Lee for overseeing our garden. As the first term rolled on, more highlights were ongoing as our students were dressed in their potential career wear for our career fair. Ms. Clarissa Hanley, along with the committee, had various workers from the community visiting the school to display their craft, from the fire truck to police officers to leather shoemaking by Suzette Fraser to soap and capsule making by Mrs. Shobana Prince of Native Radiance. To culminate the term, our Christmas concert led by our vivacious grade 5 teacher, Ms. Kimisha Sutton, was well executed as parents, family members, well-wishers filled the auditorium on December 1st, 2022 to experience a show called Rocking Around the Christmas Tree. Term 2 was another opportunity for the students of EPPS to engage in their holistic development. First off was the SJCIC NCCU quiz, where two of our grade 6 students, Kyan Blake and Sahim Pemberton, represented EPPS. Even though we did not place in this competition, the knowledge and exposure they gained will be remembered. The big highlight for this term, and I dare say the school year, was our school's 15th anniversary celebration. We had activities such as the annual anniversary church service held this year at the Gingerland Seventh-day Adventist Church, picture day, community outreach, and a visit to the old St. John's Primary School with our guide, Mrs. Eileena Mills. The unveiling of a new school sign was a proud moment for the students and staff. The Relic Festival, sponsored by A1 Farms and led by Mr. Adelvin Phillip and Sienna Leader, was the biggest event for the anniversary activities. which jump-started the sports season. This event was par excellence. For our sports day, the Green Giants again dominated and won the victory. Mention must be made of our Victor Ladorum, Ajani Brandy, one of our graduating students today. And Tinaya Wills, Victric Ladorum of grade 5. By then, Mr. Philip and Ms. Leader had a vigorous training routine for the athletes to ensure that they were ready for the big day. The Gulf Insurance Limited, Bunny Limited Inter-Primary Championship. The coaches, athletes, and their support team doubled their efforts in anticipation of the introduction of the gold medal count system for the first time. By the end of the meet, we received 4 gold medals, 4 silver medals, and 9 bronze medals, for a total of 17 medals. We are proud of our EPPS Lions. The final term of the year, term 3, came by quickly, but our spellers, Zakia Stapleton, Amir Archibald, and Jamarian Doar were ready for the Department of Education's Interscholastic Spelling Bee. By missing just one word, we emerge as the third place winners. Highest commendations to the Spelling Bee Committee, led by Mrs. Judy Usher, and the spellers for achieving this feat. Later in May, the carnival-themed fair saw students engaging in numerous fun activities such as a bun-eating competition, face painting, and a fishing game with lots to eat. Monday, the 15th of May, the Department of Gender Affairs hosted the Boy of Excellence Award ceremony, where Her Honor, Mrs. Hylita Liebert, presented this award to Kyan Blake of grade 6. And you can see his portrait there. The department's STEM week, led by Ms. Venetia Hobson of grade 3, teacher, prepared our students to engage in a STEM challenge and the STEM Expo. On May 27, 2023, Miss Earth Princess pageant took place, where Zakia Stapleton of grade 4 performed well despite not placing. We say thanks to her mother, Miss Alicia Stapleton, and chaperones, Mrs. Kevany Powell and Miss Avia Pemberton. The student council body, led by Miss Suzette Fraser and our president, Kyan Blake, was successful in hosting its first ever Elders Dress-Up Day. Students came dressed like elderly citizens to bring awareness and help to eliminate the negative stigma surrounding old age. As the year came to an end and assessments were completed, students were awarded certificates for making it on the merit roll with an overall average of 80 to 89% and the principal's honor roll of 90 to 100% average. We are here today to celebrate with the graduating class of 2023. And again, let me say congratulations to each of you. Let us put our hands together for our valedictorian, Kyan Blake. Please stand, along with your parents, and be recognized. Our top girl, Kizia Griffin, and her parents, please stand. Special recognition must also be given to Sahim Pemberton and his parents for being the other boy on the principal's honor roll. Please stand. As you may have noticed, the successes achieved this year took a shared leadership of members of the EPPS Lions team. The members of the team helped to shape my maiden voyage as principal of this prestigious institution. I ask you to join me in giving a resounding round of applause to our team. We look forward to many more opportunities and successes in the upcoming years. The physical plant. During the first term, an enhancement that was made to our school structure was the erection of a stage backdrop, which was installed as a barrier from rain and the improvement of the school's auditorium. This project was made possible by Mr. Ernie France and the TDC Group of Company Limited. As a security measure, Mr. Tash McCoy, who is our school's electrician, brightened the premises with the installation of new light fixtures and sensor lights, which enables the school to be properly lit at nights. During the second term, a new school sign was erected and unveiled. Honorable Troy Leibert, our Minister of Education, made it possible for the school's fence to be repaired, which has deterred the disturbances of animals on the school's compound. The Parent Teachers Association President, Mrs. Alicia Gilfillan, and her team assisted the school in the beautification project, where flowers were donated by Miss Christy Douglas of Botanical Gardens, were planted on the school grounds along with painting of the steps of the school's entrance. P.S. Mr. Barrett and Mr. David Titley, the school meals program coordinator, secured a top-of-the-line industrial stove and freezer for our kitchen. Thank you. To all those who have supported us this year, we do appreciate your kindness and generosity and acknowledge that the successes achieved would not have been possible without your partnership. We want to render our deepest regard for your humble gesture and intervention in the form of time, resources, expertise, affirmations, or encouragement. We extend sincere thanks to Minister Honorable Troy Leibert, Permanent Secretary Mr. Kevin Barrett, and the staff of the Ministry of Education. Ms. Zanetta Clarkson, Principal Education Officer, Mrs. Therese Doerr, Education Officer responsible for this school, other education officers, and the staff of the Department of Education. The departments within the NIA who partnered with us, agriculture, community development, gender affairs, youth and sports, culture, health, St. Christopher and Nevis Royal Police Force and the prison farms, churches, Pastor Euclid and Camilla Lawrence, as well as members of the Crossroad Community Church, Pastor Delroy Josiah, and members of the Gingerland Seventh-day Adventist Church, Pastor John Prentice, and the members of the Bethel Apostolic Church, EPS Moms at the Cross Prayer Group, Corporations, Dr. Lornette Mills Foundation, Mohan's Tire Services, OJ's Construction, TDC SL Horsford Limited, Nevis Cooperative Credit Union, SOL, A1 Farms, the Botanical Gardens, Shermer's Garden Shop and Nursery, Rudolph and Roselle Leibert Nursery, Mrs. Pazzi Wilkin and Hands Across the Seas, Russ Iroy and the Rastafari One Love Foundation. my deputy, Ms. Tamisha Sadler, and my secretary, Mrs. Kishma Wilkin Bartlett, teachers and other staff, parents, family, friends, members of the community, again, I say thank you. Let us all continue to partner together to help our nation's children become a better, stronger, and more genuine version of themselves. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Liebert. I would like to acknowledge the presence of Ms. Londa Brown, the Deputy Principal Education Officer for the Department of Education. Mrs. Liebert mentioned in her report that the graduating class holds a special place in her heart. And I hope that you guys continue to grab the hearts of many as you walk out of the halls of the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School. You may come from a class that is deemed small by many, but you, as your individual selves, are far from small. Enter rooms with your shoulders high, with your shoulders back and your head held high, for you are lions. To the sponsors, well-wishers, parents, guardians, supporters of the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School, I hope that the report met your standard or expectation, as it shows that students are excelling under the leadership of Mrs. Liebert and her staff. So I put my hands together for you guys for a job well done throughout the year. I now invite Ms. Tara Zor to give the remarks and more good news of the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School. Please welcome her.
A very blessed and pleasant good morning to everyone. Madam Chair, kindly allow me to adopt the protocol that has been established. Permit me, however, to extend an extra greeting to the 2023 graduating class of the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School. Hello, graduating students. Hi, this is for you. It's your moment to shine. I hope that you're all very proud of yourselves, for you have done exceptionally well. Graduating students, I bring you warmest greetings and well wishes on behalf of the Ministry of Education. We are indeed delighted to join with your teachers, parents, and other well wishers in congratulating you on reaching this milestone in your academic journey. Today signifies the end of a chapter of your life, but your theme clearly tells you that it is also just the beginning of yet another chapter, an opportune time to become whomever you choose to be. Graduating class, as you close this chapter, close it with belief in yourself, for you have all done exceptionally well. Close it with confidence in knowing that you are cementing a foundation that will empower you to become an even better, stronger version of yourself. Be uniquely you. Be genuine. Be genuine in all you choose to do. Keep your eyes on your goal and you will be successful. Open your new chapter with faith and the belief in yourself that you can become whomever you choose to be, but make sure you put the work in. Graduating class, there will be trials and failures along your journey, but as you grow into that extraordinary version of yourself, let every obstacle and opportunity propel you forward. The Bible admonishes us in Ephesians to be renewed in the spirit of our minds. Therefore, I urge you to take time to reflect, to learn, and to develop in order to grow into the version of yourself that you dream of becoming. Once again, on behalf of the Ministry of Education, congratulations. And as you go forth, work at your peak to become a better, stronger, and more genuine version of yourself. Thank you, and God bless you.
I hope the graduating class listened keenly and took note of everything that Mrs. Doerr has said to them. I now welcome Mr. Ian Byron. Mr. Byron is a humble, hardworking, and generous individual. He was raised in Morningstar. He attended the following educational institutions: the St. John's Primary School, now the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School, Gingerland Secondary School, and the Nevis Sixth Form College. He then completed rigorous studies in Trinidad and Barbados, after which he was employed as the air traffic controller and meteorologist at the Vance W. Amory International Airport. He has held this position for 18 years. Mr. Byron is an all-round sportsman. He represented Nevis in the field of cricket at the junior and senior level, and is known for his aggressive pace bowling. He is also an ardent domino player and usually dominates in local competitions. He believes in hard work, respect, and enjoys spending time with his lovely wife, Mrs. Stevie Byron. Mr. Byron has strong ties to this institution. He always gives generously to most of the fundraising events. He was a recent speaker who shared about the scholarship he received from TDC. He encouraged all students to strive for excellence so they too can achieve great things. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our featured speaker, Mr. Ian Byron.
Allow me to adopt the protocol established and wish ladies, gentlemen, graduates a pleasant morning. Congratulations to the 2023 graduating class of the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School. My task today is a simple but important one. It is one to share some encouraging words to help inspire our brilliant young minds before us today. Let me start with a gentle reminder. You are wonderfully made, smart, and can accomplish anything you put your minds to. Graduating class of 2023, it is an opportune time to become a better, stronger, and more genuine version of yourself. Now is the time to consciously make decisions to choose actions that will help you get there. The Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School, which is your greenhouse school, has given you the intangible tools for what is ahead. You are taught the core values of honesty, kindness, respect, along with others that will serve you well in secondary school. Your academic life from this day forward will be much different and challenging. Graduates, you are moving from an environment where you are the oldest in the school to one where you will become the youngest in the school. You are moving from a school of about 90 students to one with students of about 300. The influences on you will be amplified. We, your guardians, parents, friends, well-wishers, encourage you to rely on your good values taught to keep you grounded, as they will help you make good decisions when faced with adversity. Parents and guardians, as the outside influences on your graduates increase, so too should your fountain of support and encouragement. Guardians, I ask that you continue to supervise and check in with your graduates' progress. as the students are encouraged to be more responsible and do a lot more work and supervise, it is still important for parents to talk to them about school matters, etc. Fathers, these graduates will need that bass voice more than ever. In this, the most vulnerable time of their lives, that male presence, support, and guidance is pivotal. Secondary school is no joke. Moving from 4 subjects to a possible 9 subjects takes hard work and dedication. I know each and every one of you is more than capable of doing well. It may sound like a lot, but your math, English, science, and social studies are fundamental subjects. With those, you have already gotten an appreciation for the new subjects. Have no fear. Remember, you are intelligent and can achieve anything you put your minds to. You must use your time wisely. A studying timetable can help with time management. Do not be afraid to approach your parents and teachers about any issues and difficulties you may encounter along the way. At this stage of your life, education is priority. Anything that threatens to jeopardize it should be dropped or curtailed. Now, all books and no play make Jack and Jill dull students. Hence, I encourage you to continue your athletics, cricket, and football in secondary school. The exercise and relaxation time help the mind and body to function well. We have seen students quit running and sporting activities once they arrive at high school. This is not the wisest choice. There are endless careers in sports, and you are more than capable of attaining. Soon to be first formers, as you embark on another chapter to greatness, do not lose track of your goals. Our nation is looking in your direction for future leaders. Whether you choose to be carpenters, contractors, heavy equipment operators, doctors, lawyers, nurses, or teachers, let it be known that this small gem of an institution in the rural parish of St. John's has produced a wide range of valuable members in our society, and we are encouraging you to keep that wonderful trend going. It is now where you transform the potential you have into results. By that I mean, go and excel in academics and sports. In the same breath class, it is an opportune time for those who have not done as expected to buckle down and start the ascent to where you want to be. As our motto states, forward ever, backward never. To summarize, hold firm to your values, stay focused on your goals, make hard work and dedication your friends, and engage in extracurricular activities such as sports to be a well-rounded student. Put your best foot forward, make yourself and your whole community proud. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Byron. I hope those words did not fall on deaf ears. I know students today might seem like everyone wants to give a long speech, but every word that is said here today is to prepare you for going out there tomorrow. So many of our dreams at first seem impossible. Then they seem improbable. And then we summon the will, and they soon become inevitable. I am sure our next speaker here today thought this dream was unattainable, or was probably shocked. And so now I invite Kyan Blake to give the valedictory speech.
A pleasant morning to all. With the protocol already established, I would like to thank God for allowing us the opportunity to gather for this grand celebration. Kindly permit me to greet my fellow graduates to say congratulations. Today is one of the steps in the process of becoming the best versions of ourselves. David Viscott said, "Your ultimate goal in life is to become your best self. Your immediate goal is to get on the path that will lead you there. I implore you to take these words as a guide to light your path." As I look at my fellow graduates, I am flooded with memories of our primary school experience. I am sure all of us here are reminiscing on our first days of school, as we were anxious, excited, and wondering what the future will bring. Muhammad Ali reminds us that he who is not courageous enough to take risks will accomplish nothing in life. We certainly took a risk when we left the security of our homes and entered a new world that was destined to challenge us to be our best selves. Ding, ding, the echoing vibration of the school bell would coerce us on this new journey. Our teachers were our pillars of strength. Their encouraging words were equally helpful, which bolstered our self-confidence. They set the foundation to innovative, interactive lessons and activities. Kindergarten was awesome. Miss Wilkin was superb. She taught us nursery rhymes we had never heard. In grade one, Miss Sadler made learning a pleasure. She taught us respect and tolerance that will stay with us forever. Grade two was really and truly a test when our assigned teacher, Mrs. Liebert, left. Miss Rollins stepped in and took on the task, but her stint came to an end very fast. Miss Daniel took up the mantle and saw us to the end. She helped us through and became our very dear friend. We were excited to climb the stairs to the other grades. This meant that the standards would surely be raised. COVID met us with Mr. Zamo in grade three. Wearing masks and washing hands were mandatory. No more getting up early. Boy, we surely thought that we were off the hook, but our computer devices became our new books. Miss Stowe was there with her calming yet forceful voice. We had to learn. We had no choice. Miss Sutton in grade four was a no-nonsense kind of cheater teacher. I guess that's why we had to get her twice. Grade five meant we knew what we had to do. It was no surprise. Miss Powell welcomed us to grade six. Hip, hip, hooray, the last class, this was it. The coaches over the years ensured we were fit as a fiddle to participate in cricket, football, or athletics at the sound of the whistle. The librarian, computer teachers, and reading teachers did their part, not forgetting the security officers, cooks, and cleaners who gave us a healthy start. Kudos to the staff. We can't thank them enough when we consider what they are paid. Look at us, it's all because of the solid foundation you've laid. The respect and appreciation we have for you is immeasurable. Thank you for making us stay at EPPS so comfortable. Howard Schultz stated, success is best when shared. The various activities and competitions we participated in definitely instilled with us values that will grow whether at the career fairs, field trips, sports day, or Valentine's bake sales, student council elections, and the STEM Challenge and Expo. We enjoyed soccer size, dressing up as elderlies, and learning about the games of the yesteryear, like Mississippi, pitching, and hopscotch. For the number of memories I have to share, no doubt we will be here all year. I choose the words of an unknown author when he penned, "There are friends, there is family, and then there are friends that become family." This truly describes the friendship that we have built over the years at EPPS. We've laughed and played together and even got on each other's nerves. We've kept each other on our toes to this very end. The shouts of fuss at cricket, seeing who can hula a hoop and skip the longest, or secretly playing football in the classroom that ended up costing our parents dearly. Believe me, there were times during these games we had our disagreements, but the fun times outweighed those minor occurrences. The forgiving spirit of this group will propel us closer to being the best versions of ourselves in whatever field we choose. We've paid keen attention to each other. We've noticed that Ajinai is a lot more quieter in class than he is when we're all on the field. Let's not forget my student council president, Vice President Kizia, who's always thought our teachers had a favorite student in every class. Clifton, your admiration and your love for trucks is beyond compare. Do you remember our talk about building a car for drag racing? Our biggest achievement today is finishing primary school together and having the same admiration for each other. Special thanks to our parents, guardians, and our entire family circle for your love, hard work, and unwavering support throughout this journey. We are pleased that you've carried our lunch bags and big school bags from day one. We are grateful for your sacrifice you've made while assisting us with the new content in all subject areas. We are content with your level of firmness. It has kept us focused so we could reap the rewards today. May you keep the same energy as we go on to secondary school. To my parents, Mr. David Blake and Miss Kistely Brown, I say thank you, thank you, thank you. To my fellow graduates, I want to congratulate you on reaching this milestone. As we say goodbye to our beloved school, let us continue to roar with pride. EPPS has given us the best memories, lessons, and friendship. Let us work on the future with confidence, for I have no doubt that each and every one of us has the potential to achieve great things as long as we aim to be the most genuine version of ourselves. Remember, our grade 6 teacher, Ms. Poyle, once said that everything in life has a purpose. As we journey to start another chapter in our lives in high school, let us fulfill our purpose and dreams that is waiting for us. Forward ever, backward never. Thank you.
Well, based on crowd response, I will assume, or rather, I am making it clear that Mr. Kyan Blake has officially been dubbed the best speaker we've had all morning. As for the parents and guardians and supporters of the graduating class, I hope you've had or have some napkins here with you. Hope we're not interrupting the ceremony with your sobbing. But students, allow your parents this moment, for although this is your day and your time to celebrate, they too are proud and they too are celebrating. For just yesterday, you were two. Okay? I would like to now turn our attention to the slideshow that should be presenting at this moment. I think it would make us feel a little jolly on the inside and might be the time for you to get out those napkins. As we admire the moments that we wish were still here, we would like to invite the graduating class to celebrate, sing, dance in the form of song. This is your moment to shine, and I invite you now to take the stage. Please welcome them as they come. Oh, wow. I'm sure that all their life they've been trying to make you proud, and today they are doing that indeed. So let's give them another round of applause. The graduating class said, today is our day and we are definitely going to turn up, and that they did here. I hope that at least one or two, or as many of you, will join a choir of some sort. There are a few on the island, and I hope to see some faces there singing some songs sometime soon. I will now like to welcome Miss Shabana Powell with the presentation of certificates and awards and the turning of the tassel. Welcome, Miss Powell.
Good morning. Allow me to adopt the protocol that has ably been established. Joshua Allen, most likely to become a pilot.
There's a voice inside my head, you'll never reach it.
Please make reference to the screen for the students' awards.
Every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain.
Clesten Bartlett, most likely to become a scientist.
Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no.
Kyan Blake, most likely to become a prime minister.
I may not know it, but these are the moments.
Also added to Kyan's list of awards, most outstanding boy by Honorable Troy Liber. Janai Brandy, most likely to become an Olympic medalist. Zali Griffin, most likely to become a movie director. Saeem Pemberton, most likely to become a premier.
can almost see it. That dream I'm dreaming, but
Zion Stapleton, most likely to become an inventor.
Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be
Jaheim Sturge, most likely to become a professional footballer. Aquila Ali, most likely to become a mathematician. Hadassah Green, most likely to become a fashion designer. Kezia Griffin, most likely to become a celebrity stylist. Also added to Kezia's list of awards, most outstanding girl, the Honorable Troy Liebert Award. Julie Ken Jackson, most likely to become an entrepreneur. Zaira Philip, most likely to become a lawyer.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep
graduates, please,
my
stand.
Head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose.
Turn your tassels to the left. I now present to you the 2023 graduates of the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School.
The struggles I'm facing,
the chances I'm taking. Sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments.
Congratulations on your award. Congratulations.
Most, yeah.
You may be seated. Just remember, you can't climb the ladder of success with your hands in your pockets. You collected your awards here this morning, but this is not the end. Bask in your awards and your graduation day. Enjoy the summer and then continue on the mission to take the world by storm. Honorable Matt Brantley, I hope you mark the faces of those who are coming after your job. But at that time, you should be, you know, long gone. You can't stay young forever, I mean, I'm just saying. To keep Naomi's torch lit and to ensure no child is left behind, the Navision Association of Washington, D.C., NEVDC, established the Naomi Daniel Brown Scholarship. The scholarship financially rewards the most improved students at the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School who is being promoted from grade 6 to high school. The fund also financially rewards the most improved student being promoted from grade 5 to grade 6 at all other primary schools in Nevis. Both scholarships are rewarded annually. So please, ladies and gentlemen, put our hands together for the recipient, Mr. Jaden McDonald. Congratulations, Jaden, and keep up the good work. I actually believe that children have some of the wildest imaginations. And I encourage you parents, guardians, teachers, well-wishers, to not limit our students. And students, do not limit yourselves. Because others may think you are dreaming big. Instead, use the tools that are provided to you and make it bigger. That is your education. Use it while it is free. I now invite Jayla Elliott, Kishard Burton, and Janiyah Powell to make presentations. Please welcome them.
Robert Denario once said, "If you are in the right chair, it doesn't take too long to get comfortable in it." Ms. Jones, you are indeed comfortable in your role this morning as chairperson. We give a big thank you for taking time to spend with us. This is our gesture of gratitude to you. Thank you.
Everybody. I would like to welcome Mr. Byron on the stage. Good morning, Mr. Byron. On behalf of the graduating class of the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School, we say a heartfelt thank you for being our featured speaker. Kindly accept this symbolic token of appreciation. May God continue to bless you. Thank you.
Good morning, Ms. Brown. On behalf of the principal, staff, and students of the Elizabeth Pemberton Primary School, we present to you this token. May it be a reminder of our consistent love and appreciation for your sterling contribution throughout the years.
Thank you so much, students. I'm sure we will all appreciate the tokens when we get the opportunity to open them. I always admire when students or children are able to come and speak publicly, because I know half the adults in the room can't even hold a mic in the back and say anything. So let's put our hands together for those students. I now welcome a special presentation by Miss Cleo Bartlett. Let's welcome her as she comes.
Good morning. With Miss Principal Liebert, would you please come forward? Mrs. Liebert. So throughout our stay at EPPS, it was quite evident that the dedication of you, principal, and staff to these students' successes was only surpassed by the love that you guys have for them. To show our appreciation, the parents of the graduating class of 2023 would like to present this monetary gift towards the purchase of a PA system for the school. We will miss EPPS dearly, everything except the projects.
Thank you, Ms. Bartlett. I love when we invest in our schools. And investment in our children is one of the biggest investments and best investments we can make as a community. So thank you very much. I invite Ms. Lentricia Barry to give the vote of thanks. Welcome her.
A pleasant good morning to all. My task here is simple but small. I would like to thank Mrs. Shirley Allen for her word of prayer. Zayandra Sanaya Zanier for your lovely national anthem rendition. The welcome poem by Kenya, we say thank you. Miss Neela Jones, chairperson for this morning's graduation, thank you for being our chairperson. Mrs. Jessica Liebert for your principal's report. Mrs. Therese Dora, Education Officer for EPPS, thank you for your remarks. Featured speaker, Mr. Ian Byron, your words did not go unheard. Valedictory speech, Kyan Blake, thank you for that. graduating class, your rendition was top of the morning. We really enjoyed that. Jayla Keshad Jinaya, thank you for presenting the tokens of appreciation. And Ms. Cleo Bartlett, thank you on behalf of the graduating class for giving that monetary contribution. To our sponsors for this morning's ceremony, it would not have been possible without you. So Mr. Euclid and Camilla Lawrence, Nevis Cooperative Credit Union, Alstead and Alexa Pemberton and Family, A1 Office Technology Limited, Emily Prentice Blackett, 32 Pearls Dental, Libard Law, Bank of Nevis Limited, Pen and Paper, Dr. Linton Libard Jr., Dr. Glenville Libard, Neil Bridgman, Vera Hendrickson, Shakim Paris, Samish Kozier, First Nevis Girls Guide, Maurice Stapleton, Dr. Patricia Bartlett, Ferguson Electrical, Native Radiance, Mr. and Mrs. Ian Byron, Idris Mills, EPPS Sports Department, Charmin Challenger, Denrick and Shelley Libard, Nev DC, Naomi Daniel Brown, EPPS Parent Teacher Association, Honorable Mark Brantley, Shadone Libard, Patches Construction, Avril Charles, Steadroy Jr. Pemberton, Rastafari One Love Foundation, past students, Nevis Teachers Union, generous donor, and CSS Class of 84. We say thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Barry. Graduating class of 2023. The ceremony is officially over. However, as you start your journey, the first thing you should do is throw away the store-bought map and begin to draw your own, Michael Dell. Everyone will give you advice as to how to tackle the road ahead. That is high school. However, you have to make your own assessment and go forward. Snack time and play time will still be there. But high school is a different room, a different building with different teachers. As you go through or went through primary school, you had one teacher assigned to each class, and you were able, as a small class, to make a bond or create a bond with that teacher. As you step into high school, you see several teachers throughout the day. And as a former student of the Gingerland Secondary School, which I assume most of you will be attending, they are excited and eager and awaiting your presence. Never make yourself small. You are little in height, but be tall in ambition, be tall in courage, and be tall in everything that you wish to be and dream to be. There are so many things you can do with your life. Never, ever limit yourselves. I ask everyone to please stand at this time. And let us give the biggest applause and cheer for our graduating class of 2023. Graduates, you did it. You made yourselves, your parents, your teachers, your guardians proud, and your community. Keep going, keep walking with your head held high. I now ask you guys to remain standing as Please stand for the departure of the Deputy Governor General, Your Honor, Ms. Hylita M. Liebred, OBE, MH. Now, congratulations, EPPS Lions. You have done it, and I hope you're proud of yourselves. Now, take the walk out the building, dance, celebrate, and enjoy the rest of your day. Congratulations.